Hi, everyone. My name is Ryan Boyd.
And I'm Michael Manoochehri.
And we're from our developer relations team for Cloud Data Services. And today, or next week at Google I.O., we're going to have a number of sessions on our Cloud Data Services. And we're super excited to share these sessions with you. And we hope that during this quick video today, we can show you which sessions that we'll have and go a little bit beyond the abstracts and give you some information that will be helpful for you to decide which sessions to attend. And hopefully, you can attend all of them.
Sure.
But first of all, Michael, can you just give a quick overview of our cloud data services?
Sure. I mean, the goal of Google's cloud products has always been to expose our scalable infrastructure for developers to use to build their own applications. So we're going to talk a little bit about some of the different technologies we have available, including Data Store, BigQuery, a new product we've released, and also how to put them together and build your own web apps on this technology.
Well, fantastic. So hopefully all of you are coming to I.O. If not, catch some of these sessions on video. The Google I.O. keynotes, I believe, will be streamed, and some of the sessions will be. I'm not sure if these will, but hopefully they'll all be on YouTube for you to watch if you don't see them at I.O. itself. So we want to go through each of these sessions that we're going to have. We'll talk a little bit about them and hopefully get you excited as we are. So the first session that we're going to have is Big Data, turning your data into a competitive, your data problem into a competitive advantage. This is actually going to be done by two of our product. Who's the PM for Google Cloud Storage. And they're going to really go into the different business problems that you have with big data. You know, it used to be that pretty much everyone in the world was dealing with just very small data sets, and only companies the size of Google at internet scale were dealing with very large data sets. But nowadays, you know, pretty much everyone has a chance to get a large data set. If you launch your new mobile app and it gets onto the homepage of the Android market, you might, you know, really get a massive amounts of data that you can use to improve your applications. And so they're going to be talking about the business problem here and show you, you know, which of our tools can be used. It mixes a little bit of business and technology. It's really for those chief architects or CTO level folks who want to learn about Google's services.
It's a great introduction to the big data space. So I think if you're interested in that, you should definitely come to this talk.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, they're also going to have some external speakers come up. And one of those speakers is Beam, one of the founders of Beam. And Beam is a visualization company. And they're one of the two companies that earlier this week launched some visualization demos. You should all check them out if you didn't see those. But they launched some visualization demos showing how you can do data visualization on top of really massive data sets of half a billion rows of data on top of BigQuery. And so the founder of Beam is going to come up and show you their tool and show you how it was used for a large retail company. And then the folks at Crystalloids, another external presenter, are going to come up and talk about how they use this technology. They're kind of like a systems integrator.
I've seen their demo, and they have a great web application dashboard for the hospitality industry. It's really exciting, all built on top of BigQuery.
Yeah, so this is a good session that mixes a little bit of technology with the overall business problems that you're trying to solve. So I definitely suggest checking that out. And then the next session, of course, you should check out because yours truly is going to be giving it. But first, I want to give you a little bit of an overview on the cloud data space and what Google aims to do with these services. And this is a quote from one of our customers. A large advertising customer said, "By the time we prepared the data, we've forgotten what the question was." And you know, this is a problem when you're dealing with a lot of upfront costs, and you know, upfront both costs in terms of money, but also in terms of people and setup and all that you have with typical on-premise solutions. And this is why we love the cloud data solution space, is because, you know, Google offers services that really allow you to get up and running quickly and dive in an ad hoc iterative fashion, and you won't forget what the question was.
Yeah, sometimes what we say at Google is worry about your application, not the infrastructure itself.
Exactly. So the next session that I was talking about, that
I heard this was a good one.
Yeah. So I'm giving this session, on crunching big data with BigQuery, and I'm doing it along with one of the folks from our BigQuery engineering team, Jordan Tagani. And this session really will give you everything you need to know about BigQuery. And it's going to, you know, get for those people that are of intermediate knowledge in this space, technical folks, but then really dive deep for those people, those data geeks like ourselves that really want to know the details. So I'll give you some examples here. You know, BigQuery is a analytics service that allows you to analyze large amounts of data. And you know, it's based off of a REST-based API. And we're going to talk about that REST API, but we're also going to be talking about some of the public data sets that we make available with BigQuery that everyone here that's listening here today can go in and play around with. And the main public data set we're going to go into is the natality data set. Mm-hmm. And this is a record of all the births in the U.S. in, I think, like the last 40 years. And you can really dive into that data and see when people were born, what states they were born in, mm-hmm. And go down based off of the, you know, age of the mother and things like that.
I've seen the outline for this talk, and I think it's really incredible. The two things I've heard from developers about BigQuery is that it's both fun and empowering to use, and you're going to see how to build web applications using it and use it for analysis. It's going to be great.
And so one of the demos we're actually going to show here is using Google Apps Script to interact with BigQuery. And this is a quick little demo I built that analyzes some trends in births given by mothers, their first births given by mothers, and what the weight of the baby was and what the age of the mother was. And I break this down by red state versus blue state. I just thought it'd be kind of fun, but I'm not going to give you all the answers here, but there definitely is some differences.
People will have to either come to the talk or watch it on video to get the real answer.
Yeah, so there's definitely some differences in the age of the mother at first birth between blue states and red states, and differences even in the weight of the baby. So that's going to be kind of fun, and I'd use the Google Apps Script for this. But then the real core geek part of this session is going to be Jordan Tagani's part. And Jordan is going to really dive into the underlying architecture of BigQuery. And it's fascinating, really. So, you know, a lot of these technologies Google built internally because there wasn't any other technology for us to solve our data problems. So we built the underlying technology called Dremel and released it as BigQuery for public use, and Jordan's going to really dive into how that works, with generally the hope that understanding how the underlying technology works will help you optimize your queries. And just to give you a little hint of one of the diagrams from Jordan's part of the talk is, you know, this is the architecture of a query and how it goes through the various mixers, workers, and shards in BigQuery. And he'll explain all how that works and then dive into some really complex SQL queries to do things like 7-day active users of the GitHub data set. Another one of those public
most popular data sets that we have, yeah. And you know that you're going to learn a lot from this talk. I saw the outline, and it's a great technical overview of this type of technology.
So hope you all can make it to that one as well and see me. But you know, maybe more importantly, is coming to see Michael at the next talk.
Here's a talk you definitely should come see. So I'm going to talk about putting all of these technologies together. So I'm going to talk about data pipelines at Google scale. So in a practical sense, when you build these applications with big data, you need to use technologies that's optimized for each step in the collection of data, extracting data, transforming data, and then the analysis of it, as well as the storage. So I'm going to talk to you about using Google's infrastructure to build end-to-end applications that use a collection of technologies, including the Engine MapReduce library for doing data transformations on a large scale. And I'll show you some examples of using a data store and App Engine to collect data and serve a web application, then pipe that data into Google BigQuery for analysis. So I hope you can join us. You're going to learn a lot. If you're just sort of new to the big data space, I think this is a great overview for the different technologies available. And if you've actually done a lot of sort of MapReduce or big data transformations, come see how you can implement this type of technology on top of App Engine.
And this is technology that we're definitely using internally ourselves. We met with one of the one of our senior engineers a couple weeks ago, and he was going into how he used MapReduce on App Engine to get his data transformed and break it down to power some Google products. So it's pretty fascinating.
It's great stuff. So please stop by or watch on the video later. Oh, and then we're going to have a hands-on code lab as well. So on day one, we're going to talk about actually building an application that uses the App Engine logs as the data source. And so we're going to talk about building one of these applications that's an end-to-end data pipeline, starting with the your own Google App Engine logs of your own application, piping that data into Google Cloud Storage, and then finally, the last step is to put it into BigQuery for analysis. So you're going to sit down with some Google engineers. We have a bunch of Google engineers, including some of the engineers talking at Google I.O. On some of the big data talks. And we're going to show you how to actually sit down, write the code, and build your own application. So definitely check it out.
And the next session we want to preview for you is a session that's done by the PM of the Google Cloud Storage team, Navneet, and powering your application's data using Google Cloud Storage. Now, Google Cloud Storage is something that's fairly simple, but we've actually given you a lot of power and flexibility in this tool, and we're releasing more and more features to really enable you to build rich applications that have a lot of unstructured data. I mean, you can store tons of data in Google Cloud Storage. I think it's about 5 terabytes, I believe, for the maximum size of an individual object. So a lot of data can be stored up there, and you can access it from a lot of these other services that we're talking about here. So for instance, you know, if you do stuff on App Engine MapReduce, you can output the results of that to Google Cloud Storage. And then BigQuery can actually read in the data from Google Cloud Storage. So Navneet's going to go really into the details here of how cloud storage works, how the permissions model works, and some under other things, and especially some new features that you might be interested in if you store large amounts of unstructured data.
Great, we have another fun talk. So App Engine allows several options for storing data when you build a web application. We have a SQL, a relational data store, and also the data store itself is a NoSQL data store. And so this talk is going to talk about some of the pros and cons. It's called Battle of the Backends, and we're going to finally decide which is the best for your web application. And surely, Ryan, you agree that a SQL is the best method to store
Michael,
your data.
Oh, Michael, how naive you are. It really, the NoSQL solution, the App Engine data store, is just amazing. It's very fluid schema, and you know, I can put lots of data in it, lots of transactions, scales really
it's
well.
It's highly available. What about consistency? You've got to admit that consistency is most important.
So yeah, definitely, data store is the best one. You should definitely use data store
purposes. One word for you: transactions. That's all I'm going to say.
All right.
Anyway, I guess you have to come to this talk. We're going to have an engineer from both teams talk about the pros and cons of both, and when to choose, you know, the particular technology for your web application.
And they you know, believe it or not, they actually agree on some use cases which are good for each of them. We looked at the slides for this session, and there is some agreement there. Apparently, they've come to some consensus.
You might even be able to build an application that uses both. We'll see.
Yeah, and they'll talk about some of those use cases where you can use both. But it should be a really fun session. Like all of these, you know, we're data geeks at heart. So, of course, any session that's about data technologies, we get really excited about, and we hope you'll get excited about too. We do actually have Google Moderator, and if you're looking at the live stream here, I'm going to check, see if anyone's asked any questions. I forgot to point that out to you at the beginning of the session here, but hopefully some of you have asked some questions that we could take a look at.
Let's see here. Actually, it doesn't look like we have any questions here, but maybe we'll wait a moment and see if anyone has any questions, and then if not, we'll just wrap things up. But we really look forward to seeing you all at Google I/O. In addition to all these sessions, there are some great social events. We also do have a sandbox where a lot of external third-party companies are going to come in and show off the things that they've been building on top of our cloud technologies. A lot of things on App Engine and on BigQuery and Google Cloud Storage. So there's some great third parties that are coming and really show off what they've built, and hopefully you guys can talk with them and about what you're building, and share some knowledge with them and get some knowledge from them.
We definitely love meeting developers and seeing what you're building and what your data challenges are. Just talking to you guys helps us refine our products and lets us learn what you guys are building and how you can build your applications on our infrastructure. So look forward to meeting you there.
Yeah, it doesn't look like we have any questions coming in here, although I just did tell you about moderators, so we'll see. But, I think we should probably wrap it up. And if you do have any questions, we've actually been really active on Stack Overflow recently in BigQuery, and I believe they're using that for App Engine as well.
Yep. So if you do have any questions about these technologies, feel free to ask them on Stack Overflow. And we'll all dive in and try to help. And the community's been really active. And we have to say thank you for everyone in the community that's been really active answering questions there, too. It certainly allows us to prepare for these Google I.O. sessions and things like that. So ask your questions on Stack Overflow. Here's our Google Plus profiles as well. You can reach out to us on Google Plus. And I'll do one last refresh here and see if there's been any questions. Can we please share the slides? Yes, we can share the slides. I will post them on my Google Plus stream after the end, and Michael will probably
and
as well.
By the way, you can go to the Google I.O. website and see when the sessions are all
going to be. And I believe all the sessions we've talked about are going to be available on YouTube shortly after they're given, right?
Yeah, I don't know the exact timing, but in the past we've at least published our sessions on YouTube. So
don't worry, if you're not actually going to Google I.O., you'll be able to see all these sessions. And we usually publish the code related to the sessions and other materials. So you're going to be able to see it all.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So since we did get one question, I'll refresh here. And no, it looks like that's all the questions that we have here. So we'll wrap it up. And thank you very much for attending today. And we look forward to seeing you at Google I.O. if you're going to be there. Otherwise, we look forward to seeing you online. Take care.
Bye, everyone.